Hello peeps, out with RB and test ride on this. What can I say? Not much. Right, this came in this came in on Tuesday for a service, customer booked a service, and as you can tell, big bar mitts and heated grips and a phone holder. It's a delivery bike, Uber, whatever, Just Eat bike. He's a delivery rider. Bike needs a service. Yes, it does. When did you buy the bike? Bought a week ago. He paid £1,600 for this. It's an 18 plate. It's done 38,000 kilometres. And he paid £1,600. He's never ridden a bike before in his life. Got a CBT. Wants to go out and do delivery. Bless him. Yes, good money. Good money. Anyway, how the hell do you operate these darn controls with these stupid mitts on? I hate darn bikes. I can't get to the eating controls. Anyway, you stay there. Bugger off. He came in, we gave it a service, and he said to me, he said, oh, there's a couple of things hanging off underneath. Okay. And there was a pipe hanging off the top of the engine. What the bleeding hell was that? Ah, okay. How long have you been riding it? Oh, I've been riding it about a week. When was the last time you checked your levels? What levels? Your oil and water? I don't know, I just ride it. To say the oil was at the bottom of the dipstick is an understatement. So he changed the oil. Obviously stripping out the side of the bike. His top radiator hose had completely obliterated and melted. There is no coolant at all in this bike. He's been running it a week with no coolant in it. And what we did, obviously, phoned our local Honda dealer. God's sake, getting sick to death. Bloody bar mitts. Cannot operate these controls. And it's probably because I've got my gloves on as well. Oh well. I'll just be like everyone else and not use indicators then. So, yeah. Phoned up our local Grafton, spoke to Sue, who I know very, very well from Grafton Honda. She is an absolute godsend. Sue, I need a radiator for a Honda PCX. Yes, we can get you one. It's 3 days. It's got to come from Belgium, express delivery, and you're looking at £405 for that radiator. Oh crap. That's including the delivery, obviously. Right, so I said to him, nope, don't want to spend that much money. Right, okay, chap, go on eBay. So we sourced him the part, or I found him the link on eBay, gave him the number, said, look, we don't order it, you're going to have to order it because we're not going to get a warranty with eBay parts. So if you bought the wrong part or it's faulty, we will not offer you a warranty on that part unless you bought a brand new one. He brought the rad in this morning and we fitted it and we've topped the bike up with fresh coolant, and what was left in the coolant system was just gunge, so we've had to do a flush as well on the coolant system and obviously refill the oil, change the get the thimble filter out, give it a clean and do all the obligatories. Pumped up the tyres, 8 psi in the front and 15 in the back. Ah, God, it gets better with this thing. And then obviously one of the guys went, you taking it out? Yeah, I'll take it out and give it a road test, like I always do. But it's running, it sounds nice, and thank heavens to God, he hasn't destroyed the engine on this. I don't know how. I need a right-hand indicator. Take my glove out the mitt for the minute. Oh, this just gets better and better. If you know what I think of people with bar mitts. Yeah. There we go. Oh, put my hand back in there somewhere so I can get to the back brake and the front brake. Yes, bar mitts. What do I think of bar mitts? The only bar mitts I like are the bar mitts VAR. Or, of course, Andy GSA Tractor's bar, which I've never been invited to, but no doubt I will get round to having a few bevvies over there. But PCX is running nice. It sounds good. And we shall give him a call and say, your bike is ready. Give you a couple of tips on maintenance, my friend. How to look after your bike. If he's paid £1,600 for this and it's earning him God knows how much per hour doing his delivery, good luck, you know, he's out doing the job. Back brake is better than it was. There was no back brake on it, badly adjusted. Front brake is obviously hydraulic and is all good, but it's running. he hasn't destroyed the engine. Big thing, check your oil and water every day, people. If you're riding your bike and it's your business vehicle, check your oil and water. And obviously I'm a little bit finicky about, indicator again, hand out the bar mitts to operate it. How the hell are you meant to? It's like trying to feel your hand inside a pillow. Oh, God's sake. Turn off. Right, there we go. So, yeah, check your oil and water. And obviously, I was out Sunday doing the Super Sausage Run. Didn't video it. But while I was getting the bike out, I got the airline out. I went, you checked your tyre pressures Friday. I check my tyre pressures every time I ride, Phil. Ah, I can now actually feel the controls. I moved the bar mitt over a little bit. But I check my tyre pressures every time I ride. 42 and 42 in my bike. Something like this, you're going to have about 30 in the front and 32s on the rears. Normally for a 125, it's 30s and 32s, or anywhere within about 2 or 3 PSI of that, depending on your bike. But check your owner's manual. It's in your owner's manual, guys. But this PCX is running fine. Let's give him a call. Cheap repair for him, and he's back on the road. Just makes me want to go and deliver a pizza now. Oh, I'm talking to pizza. Starving. I need a cup of coffee and a cigarette. Oh, right. So the PCX is done anyway. So another bike done by the guys at Eclipse, even though it was me that done most of this. And of course, my trusty steed Cameron is helping me out at the moment on the bikes. Good old boy that he is. But new rad fitted, top back up with fresh oil, all cleaned out, all ready to go. And he can go and deliver away now. On to me next to get out the new WK MXI. Give that a PDI prep and test ride. And then we're on to a car this afternoon that's been crunched by a deer. Yes, oh dear. So, RB done. Back onto the yard we are. Cars everywhere. RB's bike is buried over there. We shall park this one up. But until next time, on behalf of the guys here, be well, ride safe, and it's a big goodbye from me.